Traffic Entertainment.
When you have an assumption of whites not being deserving of their success, actively working to stifle your success, plus you throw in Black Lives Matter Pan-Africanism, media pushing selective outrage stories of white-on-black brutality, constant political fear-mongering about Trump being racist, his supporters being racist, the whole of America being racist, pop culture infatuation with shaming and demonizing whites, academic institutions teaching bullshit like power plus prejudice theory, reinforcing already held biases and divisions, the manipulative obsession of historic racism being exploited to fuel present emotional hostility.
So 400 years gonna stop 2 years ago. Hey, so 400 years gonna stop 2 years ago.
Hey. Black people in America have become the most psychologically vulnerable and easily exploitable demographic for progressive agitators. Now, I'm not saying that things like racism, police brutality, discrimination, etc. don't exist. Of course they do, but that's so obvious I'm not even gonna spend time explaining that simple fucking fact as a preemptive counter just because some idiot will try to frame this video as me cooning or trying to impress the white man. If you think that, fuck you. This video isn't for you anyway. You're already in the same camp as Brittany and these other societal hazards. You've lost all rational nuance in your perspective. If you're the type of person who tries to justify acts like this, by pointing to historic events that happened hundreds of years ago, then you're already too far gone to reason with. All we can really hope for people like you at this point is that your stupidity be contained, and that if you just so happen to try and execute terroristic acts against innocent people, that you hopefully be shot dead on the fucking spot. But for those who don't think like this, for those who haven't become completely trained pawns for leftists, don't fall victim to their will. These collectivist race hustlers out here, they want you to hate each other. They want racial violence. They want you to self-segregate. Luckily, I was able to escape this mental entrapment early on. And, place priority value on individualism. And it led me to develop an awesome outlook on life. No longer do I wander through life with a subconscious envy or anger towards white people, or anyone for that matter. Over the course of this past year alone, I've met so many amazing people who are white. People who I know I could count on to go out of their way to help me succeed in life, both personally and professionally. I've begun to try and understand police and law enforcement better. Granted, there's still a huge array of shit that I don't really fuck with when it comes to 12. But I'm trying to communicate more and assume less. I'm trying to listen more than I criticize. And it's such a better state of mind. I can't tell you what to do. And I'm not trying to say that all blacks suffer from this, or that there's no legitimate reasons for some black people to hold rancorous attitudes toward whites. All I'm really suggesting is that you try and maintain love.
For my motherfucking nigga, most likely I'ma die with my finger on the trigger. I've been grinding that side all day with my niggas, and I ain't going in unless I'm with my nigga, my nigga, my nigga.
Traffic Entertainment.
My nigga, my nigga, my motherfucking niggas. My nigga, my nigga, my nigga, my nigga, my nigga, my nigga.